Hey, in today's video I'll be explaining how a clutch works in a manual transmission. In Europe, most of cars have a manual transmission. Even if modern technologies are heading towards using automatics due to efficiency and comfort reasons, I strongly believe that manual transmissions will continue to coexist with automatic ones. A manual transmission uses a third pedal which disconnects the gearbox from the engine. To do that, we need a release bearing, a pressure plate, a friction disc, and a flywheel. I have been recently invited in Romania to a car event in which I've seen lots of car parts and brands. There was a stand from Schaeffler in which we could observe how a clutch worked from detail. We could press the clutch pedal with our hand and observe how the clutch actually works. The flywheel is attached to the crankshaft and they move together all the time. The flywheel also has a crown which helps us start the engine. The friction disc stays in contact with the flywheel and the pressure plate. When we press the clutch pedal, we actually press on the release bearing which presses on the pressure plate and it disengages the gearbox from the engine. The pressure plate has a diaphragm spring. When it's pressed, it temporarily disconnects the engine from the gearbox. And that's when we shift gears and that's when we start from standstill. The friction disc uses ceramic materials to ensure the proper friction force. Older friction discs used to use asbestos and other harmful materials, but they're not used anymore, so don't worry about that. Performance clutches uses copper ceramics, which are much more efficient at higher temperatures compared to a conventional clutch. Also, the friction disc comes with a few couple of springs. The springs are meant to reduce shocks, and the shocks generally go to the gearbox. So to protect it, engineers came up with this simple solution. Depending on the type of the engine, we have slightly different clutch kits. For example, in diesel engines, we have double mass flywheels, which tend to be 3 to 5 times more expensive compared to a single mass flywheel clutch kit. Why do we need a double mass flywheel? Well, we need to reduce shocks, we need to preserve the gearbox, and we need to have a smooth operation. We could convert from a double mass to a single mass, but it's not recommended. Single mass clutch kits are generally found in gasoline engines and they're way more cheaper. For example, in my Audi A3 with a 1.6 engine, the clutch kit replacement costs around $200. If I had a 2-liter turbocharged diesel engine, a clutch kit replacement with a double mass flywheel would cost me around $700, so it's a huge difference. In terms of cost, manual transmissions are way cheaper compared to automatic ones. They're cheaper to purchase, they're cheaper to maintain, and they're way more reliable compared to an automatic. You don't even need to necessarily change the oil in a manual transmission, but if you really want to, you should at around 125,000 kilometers, or at least when you replace the clutch kit. You also don't have any fancy sensors, the operation is simple, and everything is more reliable. I will create soon another video in which I will discuss about the main problems that may occur in a manual transmission, so stay tuned for that. So this is how a clutch works in a manual transmission. If you have anything else to add, please feel free to write in the comment section below. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll talk to you guys in the next one.